Centrifugal pump startup procedure. It is a very easy step-by-step activity which will should be carried out for lining up of the start of the centrifugal pump we are going to see. Initially, we want to ensure that after the maintenance, all the flanges, all the vents, drains, all it should be in closed condition, and bolts all it should be tightened, pump should be in coupled condition, and it should be healthy. All the permits which are applied for the maintenance, or it should be get signed off, we want to ensure all of those. And pump healthiness we want to ensure from electrical side, whether in case of the motor is shut in for the long time, so it should be better to go for the megger, checking the megger resistance of the motor, it is healthy or not, to avoid the motor damage or winding damage. And then all the transmitters, trip pressure switches, or the pressure safety transmitters, it is all lined up or not, we should ensure it. In case of temperature, we have the any trip, so it should be in line, or it should be healthy, we should ensure it. After ensuring that, the main activity in that centrifugal pump, we want to displace all the air which is accumulated in the suction pump casing. We want to evacuate, want to push it back, that air with the liquid, in order to get the proper pumping. When there is any air packet available in the pump suction or the eye of the impeller or the inside the casing, definitely pump will not work. It will not do what is our requirement where we are placing the pump. Only in the centrifugal pump we have the flooded suction. That means the liquid which is available up to the pump discharge nozzle, or suction pressure will be greater. That means greater than the atmospheric. So easily the liquid will get passed through up to the pump casing discharge nozzle. So in terms of suction lift, it will be not there. We should prime the pump with the help of additional liquid. Want to introduce additional liquid, suction will have the footwall in the pump, or check valves will be there. So it will be in the closed conditions when we apply the water here. So it will be get filled in the suction line. Whatever the air available in the suction line will be get passed through the pump casing, and then it will bleed off to the discharge. Here, theoretical representation is for the flooded suction. So in this case, after ensuring the all the flanges tightness, after all everything healthy, then we should ensure that suction is closed, discharge is closed condition, all the transmitters, everything what we said, we lined up, and drains are closed and vents are. Here the discharge vent, it should be in open to vent out all the air which is accumulated in the suction line. Whenever there is the eco-friendly liquid we are handling, that means we can line up directly, and we can, with the help of secondary containment, we can line up the vent, so it will get passed through the secondary containment, the bucket, the trays. Water will be get splashed out, then we can isolate the vent, then we can go for the short attempt. But in case of non-eco-friendly liquid, that means any corrosive or poisonous or not advisable to put in the environment, that in that case, again, we want to go for with eco-friendly liquid that is in the even. It can take us the water, can end up in the suction, discharge vent will be in open condition. So once the water is get splashed out from the discharge vent, we can isolate this water which is lined up for the suction and the discharge vent. In this case, we have the flooded suction. If we take, we want to line up the suction wall, always getting open. So the liquid will get passed through from the suction side to the downstream of the suction wall. So well, the water is, the liquid is entering into the suction line, what will happen, whatever the air which is present in that, it will get pushed along the liquid flow. So automatically the whatever the air available in the suction line and the pump casing will be pushed out to the discharge, what we said. So all the air you just lifted out you push it out. It is called the priming, basically. It is the priming. Priming is nothing but you're filling the liquid up to the discharge nozzle of the pump, from suction up to the discharge nozzle of the pump, and completely evacuating the air from the system. That is called priming. Once it was done, the discharge valve, actually the procedures, we can go through the pump vendor standard operating procedures. We should go through it. Or pump startups, whatever the industries we are following, that we can go through. But basically, in case of centrifugal pump, we should close the discharge and then we want to start the pump, or we can open, crack open it. Because why? Because while starting the pump, the motor initially, it will take 6 times of its rated current. That is full load current, it will take 6 times of its full load current. For example, 10 ampere is the full load current. It will take minimum 60 amperage during that startup. So when the discharge also get open, what will happen? All the liquid which is lined up will get, also open condition. So it will get pushed out, pushed back, pushed up. All the liquid will get pushed up. So this also will take more energy. So motor also already taking more energy, and pump can, even it can trip. To avoid that, we want to open the discharge crack, and it should be closed condition only. And some of the cases, when the motor is get designed, the motor and pump is get designed, in that case, higher capacity motor is installed, that will be no problem. In the 100% discharge throughput also, it will not trip, means we can keep open. Whenever the auto start of the pumps, discharge automatically will be in open condition, full open condition, then we can start the pump. In that case, we should go for the higher capacity of the motor, which should handle that much liquid during the initial startup. So it is a case. So in this case, discharge is closed condition. That is, you can make keep crack open also. Don't confuse. No need to confuse in that discharge. You can make crack open or you can fully close it. Two options we can make. After that, liquid is filled up to the pump discharge nozzle. When it is closed condition, then you can give start attempt to the pump. So pump will get rotating. Pump is rotating now. Then pressure will get build up. So after the 5 seconds or 3 seconds, you can start opening the discharge valve. So open the discharge valve, the liquid will get passed through the downstream of the discharge valve. So now pump is coming into the line and it is giving a sufficient flow requirement to our process requirement. We should go for the LLF, whether a pump motor is having any vibrations or any sound from the bearing. And then pumps, you want to check in vibrations, bearing, everything. You want to check it from bearing, everything. And everything is okay. Then suction line, so discharge line, there is no leak and everything is normal. Then we can proceed for the next activity. This is the simple procedures and what are the activities involved for this centrifugal pump startup.